y'all doing today? This is Mike Hines here, Wildlife Outdoor Survival. Just want to show y'all what I've been to today. I'm down here and I'm doing pretty much just a mock survival lean-to shelter. Just gonna take some limbs, some vines, kind of build a little lean-to shelter, something just get you through for a little while. Have two situations for us. But what I'm gonna do, y'all, I got a group of trees here, I got a group of trees here. I'm gonna put me a ridge across here and have my back side of my lean-to be on that side. One of the first things we've done when we come in here, of course I start clearing some little underbrush, but make sure there's nothing overhead that's on, you know, big limbs that could blow out and fall out if the wind gets up. Rotten, dead tree type stuff like that, but fortunately, the area we're in, not a lot of big trees, that's pretty much all there is. I'll kind of show y'all the area and stuff where we're at. We actually got like a little water source, a little creek runs down through here, probably 150, 200 yards away. Another thing we considered, there are a lot of edible resources, right? Plant life, stuff like that we could eat. Small game. But anyway, y'all, I'm gonna get started clearing this stuff out, and we'll see what happens next. Y'all, one thing I'm doing, I'm not just clearing this out, but as I'm clearing it, I'm finding stuff I can use to work with this shelter. Like my little dead tree limbs is falling out and stuff. I'm going to pile that off to the side, use it, maybe for firewood later, start a fire. Right here is honeysuckle vine. This stuff, when it's green, pretty much like Mother Nature's rope. See how this has grown and it's just wrapped itself around and around and around. Gonna unbraid that. I'm gonna use this for a cordage. Tie our shelter together with. I'm gonna show y'all how flexible this stuff is. Now the smaller part of it, it's more brittle. But you can see, you can pretty much wrap that stuff around and around. And if it does start to break on you and you have time, you can always roll it up, put it in a little stream or container water or something, let it kind of soak and it'll make it a little more flexible. But I think this will work just fine, what we're going to do. And I about got it cleared out, y'all. I'm working on it. We still like a little bit more, but I'm going to go and put some more of this stuff out. Oh, there's some more firewood. That's just stuff that's falling out of the top of the tree. Y'all can see this or not. Y'all know I was telling you earlier, not a lot of big trees. I don't know if y'all can see that or not. The trees that are here are old rough, wild thorns, hackberries. Probably gonna have to build a shelter out of some of this stuff, so. I got a pretty good idea of what I might do. That one got so many needles on it, we're gonna lay it to the side. Let it dry, we'll use it for firewood later, maybe. Got it cleared out. Already cut me a piece for my ridge across the top, but like I was telling y'all, I don't know if y'all can see that or not, but thorns. About the only kind of material in here, but we didn't have a lot of choice about where we were going to be at, so we're just going to take and knock those thorns off best we can. And I got a plan, y'all. I think what I'm going to do, since I'm going to have to use this kind of material, I found a couple of cedar trees I can cut some boughs off of. And I'm going to try to line my shelter with those cedars in between the thorns. Y'all, I'm going to get this ridge pole cleaned up and we'll get ready to put it up. Thing I brought with me today, y'all. Little Eagle Knife Company machete from Hayden, Alaska. Alright, y'all. I got this thing about cleaned up. What I'm going to try to do, y'all, I'm just going to try to wedge this thing in between these little cluster of trees and see if we can't make something to support itself. Maybe. Grapevine in there that's growing up the tree, that's going to help support it on this side. Okay, y'all. I think it's going to be plenty of support for things we feel. Okay, now what I'm going to do. I'm gonna go put me a couple of sticks to go right down this side. And back this way, be my outside support for my roof. We'll see if we can't get them cut, y'all. Alright, y'all, I got my two pieces cut. Oh, look at her. Told y'all about them thorns. Wish we had some other kind of stuff around here to use, but we'll get it. It'll take a little while long cutting all thorns off. Y'all, we probably ain't got about an hour and 15 minutes before dark. We're gonna have to get this stuff going. Talking about these thorns, y'all. I mean, they're kind of rough, but you know, in certain situations, I had to. I guess you could take them. You get one of these things off of you, I'll show you what I'm talking about. That's a thorn, y'all. But, on the lighter side of it, I guess, survival situation, if I had to, first thing I think of, I think I could take that, make me a fish hook. Maybe use this whole thing, lace a worm on there, make me some cordage, tie it around this knotted end up here, drop it off in this little creek, we may try that, y'all. But, I'm sure that would probably hook a fish. Anyway, I gotta get back to the shelter, y'all. I just wanna show y'all that. But, we don't get this thing built, it's gonna get dark on us. Trying to put the smaller end at the top to reduce weight on the shelter. Right. I think that's gonna work. I'm making this thing kind of steep, y'all. Probably not going to get a lot of rain, but just in case. The deeper I make this thing, the more water shed off the back of it. And tonight we're just gonna get the lean-to part built, maybe in the morning or something. We may build a front on here, some kind of little slant to the front. But anyway, we're gonna try to get this thing done, y'all. What I'm gonna do, I'm telling y'all about this honeysuckle. That's what I'm gonna use to lash this stuff together with. It ain't gotta be nothing pretty, it ain't gotta be no certain kind of knot. As long as you get a little something to support. And really, the lashings aren't really gonna support a lot. But what they are gonna do is hold everything in place, keep it from shifting if the wind gets up or heavy rain. I get scared at night, jump up or something. We don't want this thing to come crashing down. Find a better piece of honeysuckle. Here we go. Okay, y'all, next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to run some across this way. I'm probably going to run about three runs across the back here, and I'll get them cut, y'all. Okay, y'all, I just went and cut me a couple of limbs off one of these locust thorn trees. I'm not going to worry about taking the green off, because I'm going to be covering the top of green anyway. So, what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna lay these things across the back and lash them to it. I went and got me some more honeysuckle vine. Use that for some lashes. Thank you. one side, got it binded together. I hear that gravel road over there. Somebody going down the road anyway. Very seldom we hear a car back in this part of the country. Here we go, here's a good one. I'm gonna go on and put the, might put three more. I'm gonna put at least three or four across there. Alright y'all, it's trying to get dark on us, but as y'all can see, I got my braces across the top. And y'all know how I was talking about showing y'all all these thorns and stuff. Well, that's the main thing I'm gonna have to use to cover my shelter with. But I got to look around, I found a couple cedar trees out there. So what I'm gonna do, cut off some of the cedar bale. What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna race these things inside over and under like that. Back and forth. Start at the bottom to the top, that way anything gets run off. Mainly what this layer is for is just to keep the thorns away from it. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna put a layer of this down, the cedar bale down. Then I'm gonna take some longer limbs of the thorns and hackberries and old rough trees, still with the leaves on them, cover it again, and then I'm going to do another layer of cedar bale. And what that's going to do is give me like an airspace, insulation more or less, keep it a little warmer in the cold, a little cooler in the hot, maybe, you know. But that's what I'm going to try, y'all. These, it's not all they're going to strengthen it, it's going to help pull everything this way, so it kind of takes the swag out of those limbs. It kind of tie everything together, and then by the time I get my other two layers on it, it should be pretty sturdy. We're just going to keep on layering and layering and layering, y'all, fast as we can. I hate finishing a shelter in the dark. I hate trying to get set up at all in the dark. I just run out of time before I got here today. Thank you. All right, y'all. I know we're about to lose camera light. We about got this thing done. It's gonna start raining again, but I don't know if y'all can see. I don't know if y'all can see anything at all, really. Camera light's about out. But anyway, y'all, I'm gonna go and finish this up. All I like to put one more layer on there. Like I said, y'all, we've just done the basic lean-to right now. We're gonna go and use this tonight, tomorrow morning. We'll probably do a little front, kind of a slope on the front too. So anyway, y'all, I'm gonna go and finish this up where I got a place to lay down, and I'll see y'all in the morning.